morning children, welcome to online class. Children, in previous class I taught you about fraction and given you notes related to fraction. Today I will teach you decimal. Students, today's topic is decimal. So first I want to explain you what is a decimal. Decimal is a number expressed in the scale of tens. Our decimal point is a point or dot. Used to separate the whole part of a number from the fractional part of a number. We use the dot to separate the whole part of a number from the fractional part of a number. Suppose 7.3456. See, we use here decimal point, and these points, before points, this number is the whole number. This number is called whole number, and this one is the fractional part of a number. So the dot is in decimal numbers is called a decimal point. The dot in decimal number, in this number, this dot is called decimal point. What is the decimal points? This dot is called the decimal point. Okay, you can say a decimal is a number that has a decimal point. Somewhere in the number, the numbers on the left side of the point represent whole number, such as this number is suppose one another example of decimal numbers, we will take 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.23456. Okay students, what I told you, decimal is a number that has a decimal point. Somewhere in the number, the numbers on the left side of the point represent whole number. Left side of the number means this number represent whole number. And how to read this whole number? You said this one is the ones, and this one is the tens, and this one is the hundred, and this one thousand, and this one is the 10,000. Means like that we are reading. Before the left side of the decimal point, we read the ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, and the right side of the point are the decimal values. Then how we read this one? This one is the tenth, and this one, hundred. hundred. And this one is the thousand. This one is the 10,000. Like that we are reading. Okay. Now, what is the decimal? Decimal is a number expressed in the scale of tens. And decimal point is a point or dot used to separate the whole part of a number from the fractional part of a number. And decimal numbers are the numbers that are written according to their place value. And decimal point used to separate, already I explained it, used to separate the whole numbers from the fractional part. Now listen, in this chapter I will explain you how to find the parts or fractional parts to convert this fraction to decimal, and decimal, how to convert decimal to fraction. See here, how to represent the decimal numbers. One example I will take. See here, before I explain you, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total parts is 5. Suppose this part I said it, these two parts I said it here. So how to write in fraction? What I told? In fraction how to write? infection. I told you, he first count the number. How many boxes are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The fraction in the down, you have to write the total number of boxes. And how many boxes added here? 1 and 2. The 2. We will write 2. Now, this one is the fraction 2 by 5. And we have to convert it into the decimal. It is very easy. Simply you divide this one. 5 is the divisor here and 2 is the dividing. See, 2, 5. 2 is less than 5. So we will put here point. So we will get the here 0. 5 fours are 20. That means here that is the 0.4. 0.4. In decimal, we will write this one. Decimal, we will write 0.4. 2 by 5, that means 0.4. Now, these are the way to convert fraction to decimal. By dividing the number, we can easily convert it into the decimal form. Students, see, in decimal, you have to learn how to add the number and how to multiply the number, how to subtract the number, how to write the decimal numbers in ascending order or descending order. And also you have to learn the division. Before that, I will tell you one thing, how to read the decimal number. Students, how to read the decimal number? One example, 7, 4, 5.123. Listen, how to read the number? I told you, this one is the 10th. This left side of the decimal point, this one is the whole number, and we will read this one is the ones, this one is the tens, and this one is the 100. Means 745. 745. And this one is the, what is this? Point. The point. And after then, you have to read the number as it is. What is written? You have to read as it is. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Simply, we have to read the number 1, 2, 3. Okay. Next, suppose 245.456. So, how to read the number? This one is the 1, 10, 100, 245.456. You have to read the simple number. You have to read the 4, 5 and 6. See, next, how to add the decimal number? How to add the decimal number? Your first decimal number, addition of the decimal number. Addition of decimal number. Questions I will take from your book. 23, we will read together, then 0.11. It will not 11, it will be 11. And the next one is the 3.24. Now, students, see, this one is already arranged and given. But if suppose one question is given here, 4.567 plus 3.24. It is not arranged. You have to arrange. Then how? You have to arrange this number. I will explain you. Now first you add this number. Here this one is a 10. This one is a 100. You have to start from this side. 4, 1, 5, 1, 2, 3. Simple addition you have to do. Point as it is. You have to write point. 3, 3, 6, and this one is the 2. Now this one is already arranged, then easily you can add this number. But if any number is given in this way, then how to arrange, I will explain you step by. So write down the numbers one under the other with the decimal points. What we have to do, write down the numbers one under the other with the decimal points. So, what is written with the decimal points lined up? Okay. What is written first? 4.567. 4.567. That is written the first. And second number is given here. 34.24. Students, see, here only once is given. Here once and tens is given. So in place of ones, you have to write the ones. And in place of tens, you have to write the tens. Here no tens is there. So no need to write here. In place of ones, you write. What is in ones here? What is ones here? Four. Four is ones. So in the noun, you write four. And in place of tens, you have to write tens. And as it is after the point, what is written? 2, 4. Nothing is written here. No, don't write. Okay. Now, first what I did here, we have to write the numbers one under the other with the decimal point line up. With the decimal point lines up. If you have any confusion, then put in zero so the numbers have the same length. Put the zero. Where is the no number? You can put the zero there. Here no number is there, you can put 0. Here no number is there, you can put 0. Okay, put in 0 so the numbers have the same length and you don't have any confusion. Okay, then add using column addition. And simple addition you have to do. How to add the using the column addition, remembering to put the decimal point in the answer. You have to 7 plus 0, 7, 6 plus 4, 10, 0, 1 is carry here. So 1 plus 5, 6 plus 2, 8. And you have to remember the points, you have to put the point here. And 4 plus 4, 8. And 0 plus 3, 3. So, in addition, what we have to do? In addition, first, I told you, you have to write down the numbers, one under the other, with the decimal point line up. Okay, with the decimal points lines up. If no number is there, then in place of put in 0, so the numbers have the same length. Put the 0, so the numbers have same length. And you don't have any confusion. Then add using the column additions and write the answer. That is your answer. Okay. Now, students, see. This one is the rule of addition. What I told, rule of addition, ki first you write the numbers, then you have to put the zeros, so the numbers of length will be the same, and after that, as a simple addition, column you add the column and put the points. Same way, we have to do the subtraction also. Now, what is the steps for subtraction? See here, subtraction. Subtraction, for subtraction is also same as the addition. In that questions, one question I will take from your book only. See, what is the question here? 273.04 minus 154.26 minus. Students, here already everything is arranged. Means number is arranged here. You have to simple do the subtraction word. So, here first see, we have to start from here. 4 minus 6 is not possible, so it we will take carry and it will be the 14, and 14 minus 6, that will be the 8. Then this number will be 9. 9 minus 2, that is 7. And already I given one carry here, so this number will be 2. And 2 is less than 4, so again we will take carry from 7, then it will be the 12. 12 minus 4, 8. Now this number will be the 6. Now 6 minus 5 is 1 and 2 minus 1 is 1. This one is the 118.78. That is the simple subtraction. But if I told you, ki subtract the number, 3.25 minus 2.5 2.13. So what we have to do? First we write the same steps. You have to write the states first. 3.25 minus what is written? This number is 1. So in the term down of the ones you write 2. Point is written. So you write the point. After point what is written? 1, 3. And after then you have to do the subtraction. 5 minus 3 is 2 and 2 minus 1 is 1 and 3 minus 2 is 1. 1.12. So addition and subtraction you have to do the same way. Students, it is very important to write carefully the decimal points and decimal numbers. If you will not write the proper way, it will be totally wrong. Means one example I explain you. Suppose 7.45 plus 2.5. What is written? 7.25. So what children do the mistakes here? 7.45. So where we you have to, this one is okay. If this one is a ones place, you write two ones. Point is there, point is here, right? But 5, where you have to write the 5? Here or here? No. After the point, what is written? 5. The after the point, just point, you have to write the 5. Not here. After the decimal points, you have to write this one 5. And here nothing is given. You can put the 0, 5 and 5 plus 4, 9. And this one is the 7 plus 2, 9. This one is the correct answer. If you will write here 5, then it will be the wrong. Okay. Now, next question is the multiplication. How to multiply the decimal numbers? Decimal numbers multiplication is also very easy. You have to do the simple multiplication and after that you have to put the points. Okay, now see one question I will take from your book. 12.45 multiply 7. So forget the decimal points and write how to write 12.45 multiply 7. Students, see in how to multiply the decimal numbers. If you want to multiply a decimal number by whole number, just ignore the decimal points. That means you forget that these decimal points for few minutes. Okay, just ignore the decimal points and multiply like normal multiplication. Then bring the decimal points back for the answer. That means you have to count the number of digits after the decimals in each factor. Okay, and finally put the same numbers of the digits behind the decimal in the product. Okay, means during the multiplication time you have to forget these decimal points. Don't remember these points and simple multiply you have to do. 7 5s are 35. What is carry here? 3. Then 7 4s are 28, 29, 30, 31. 1. And what is carry here? 3. 7 2s are 14 plus 3, 17. 1 is carry here. 7 1s are 7 and 8. Okay. Means here what is here 88715. Simple multiply, we do the simple multiply and I told you ki you have to just ignore the decimal points and multiply like a normal multiplication. Now we multiply the like a normal multiplication. Then next step what we have to do, we have to bring the decimal points back for the answer. That means we have to count the number of digits after the decimals in each factor. Here after the decimal how many digits are there, we have to count. See how many digits decimal points is here, how many digits here? 1, 2. How many digits here? 2 digits are here. So from the there 3 digits behind the factors, we have to take from here. We have to count from the this side. 1, 2. Up, counting 2 digits after the decimal points, 2 digits are there. So from the this sides we have to start counting 1, 2. Here we have to put the point. After 2 digits we have to put the decimal points. Okay. Only here what in short I will explain you what you have to do. First you have to do from your mind, remove the decimal points from your mind. First step is remove the decimal points. Remove the decimal points. Points from your mind. From your mind. Okay. First point. First point. Remove the decimal points from your mind. Second step. Multiply it simply. Multiply it. As a simple multiplication. As a simple multiplication. Simple multiplication. Okay. Multiply it as a simple multiplication. And after then place a decimal in answer. See here how many digits are right side of the decimal points. How many? Third is the C. Right side decimal points, after the decimal points right side, how many digits are there? Here 2 digits are there. So in the down, in the answer, you have to count 2 digits and you have to put the decimal points. Only 3 steps are here. You have to ignore the decimal points from your mind. Second step is multiply it simply. And third step is place a decimal in answer. See here how many digits are right of the decimal points. We have to here 2 digits after the right of the decimal points. That is what is given there, 4, 5. Okay. So we have to count the decimals and put the decimals in the answer. Now these are the way to add, subtract and multiply the numbers. Students, one simple multiplication. Suppose here 1.243 multiply 10. So what we have to do? No need to write like that 243 multiply 10 and again we have to do the 0 and 0. Directly you can write there one digit. We will remove from here one digit. 12.43. Okay. If it will be the 243 multiply 100. So you remove just 2 digits here. Okay. Now 124.3. Like that we have to multiply and write the answer. So these are the way to multiply the numbers, decimal numbers. Deci means 1/10 of the given number. Okay. Same way we have to do the divide work, division work also we have to do the same way. How to divide? Move the decimal points in the divisor and divide it. Place a decimal point in the quotient and directly above where the decimal points now appear in the divided. And divide as usual, being carefully to line up the quotient properly. So that the decimal points falls into the place. Okay. Now one question I am taking from your book. See. 116.8 divide 8. So write this one. 8 is divisor. 116.8 is dividend. So first we divide here 11. 2 digits see here 11. One time 8 minus 8 ones are 8. Here 3. This number will become down 6. 8 fours are 32. 8 fours are 32. So we write here 32. Then it will be the 6 minus 2 4. And 3 minus 3, 0. Nothing is there. So, now we get the 4 as a quotient. What units are left here? Now change 4 units into the 10th. That means 4/10th we will take this number in the down. This number we will take this number in the down 8. And what is written here? Point. So we will put here point. And now this number is a 48. The 8. How many times it will be 48? 8 6 are 48. Now subtract this number and see what is the answer. 14.6 will be the answer. We have seen that if there is or 10, 100, if any number, the process of division is as same as the division of whole number. Okay. Now, students, all the notes I will give you in next class. So you have to write and do the practice of all the chapters till decimals. Your midterm portion is till decimals, means you have to do all, you have to solve all.